Welcome back to my channel. If you are new, my name is Mary and I'm so happy to have you here for today's video where we are going to be talking about where I've been, what I've been doing, and how these things are positively impacting my ability to manifest my dream life. I've only been doing YouTube for about 9 months now, and if you look at how many videos I've posted, it's kind of a lot. Like, I don't know, it's like 60, 70 plus videos, because for a long, long time, the first like, I don't know, maybe 6 months I've been on YouTube, I was making it a point to post 2, 3, 4, sometimes more videos per week on YouTube. And that takes a lot of work. Like if you see a YouTube video that's 10 minutes, there's a good chance that video took anywhere from like 2 to 4 hours to record and produce. So I was really focused my first 6 months being here of growing my channel and putting a lot of energy into doing that. But by focusing so much energy on this end goal of channel growth, I was neglecting myself and my own health and wellness. So I've talked a lot on this channel about how in order to manifest something, it's really important to do things that feel good to you. So for some people who believe in the law of attraction or the law of assumption, just affirming is something that feels really good to them and feels very comforting for them. And so that is all that they do to manifest. For other people like myself, affirmations, visualizations, gratitude exercises, and then sometimes other things really feel good to them and to me, and those are the things that we use to manifest. I don't think that there's any one right way to follow the law of attraction or to manifest something, and if anyone tells you that there's only one way to do it, which happens to be their way, and they'll tell you if you pay them, they're lying to you. So there are a lot of ways to do this, and it's all about finding what feels good to you and feels natural for you. So over the past few months, I think like ever since getting married to Derek, I've really made it a point to start prioritizing my health. It is no secret that the number one thing that I'm trying to manifest right now, aside from my usual things like health and money and happiness and those kind of things, the very specific thing that I'm trying to manifest now, my specific person, if you will, is a baby. We are wanting to start a family within the next year. And so as a result of that, I've really been focusing on my health and making sure that my body is in the best position possible to be a good home for our baby for 9 months. So I've been eating really healthy, sleeping more, exercising, taking good supplements, meditating, yoga, all of those good things. If you follow my Instagram, you'll see I've been trying to post a lot more on my Instagram stories. It's just Mary Lou on IG, showing like going for daily walks with my dogs or morning yoga or drinking coffee by the pool in the morning or whatever. I try to start my day off from this place of peace and gratitude. And lo and behold, I have found that by focusing on my health, my own ability to manifest has been like supercharged. I've been manifesting so many like super awesome random things just constantly that ever since I started making my health and wellness a priority, as an example, professional achievement and as a result, money is something that's very important to me. And I was actually recently invited to sit on an academic advisory board position with a really, really well-known university based on my own like professional skills, not my law of attraction stuff. They don't care about that, but like my own professional skills as a working lady. So that's a huge accomplishment for me. And that wasn't even like a specific thing that I was trying to manifest. I wasn't trying to manifest a board position. It's just something that came to me because my end result of professional achievement and satisfaction and money is in line with that. Like this board position is gonna help me get there. And it just kind of fell into my lap once I prioritized my health. When I was posting on YouTube 2, 3, 4 times a week, I was exhausted, okay? Like I would record all in one day. At the very start of my time on YouTube, I was making it a point to like have all of my makeup perfect, my hair just right, change out outfits, change out backgrounds, like all this stuff so that I could get it perfect, but it was taking me like a full day of recording and two or more days per week of editing to be able to produce that much content. And that's in addition to having a full-time job. So like all my time was going into my YouTube, which means I wasn't preparing and eating healthy foods. I was eating a lot of pre-packaged processed foods like frozen dinners and just bowls of cereal or whatever to get myself by so I could just work on this goal. And it's so interesting because at a certain point when I had around like 400 subscribers, I kind of plateaued and I've been sitting in the 400s for a long, long time now. And over the last few months, I haven't been posting as many videos. I haven't spent as much time editing them. You'll notice I've cut out some of the sound effects, pictures, graphics that I used before, and I'm more focused on the quality of the content that I'm producing and not the quantity or the special effects. I've cut back on that, you know, and it's so funny. I stopped really hyper focusing on growth and just recorded videos that felt good to me, didn't invest so much time in them that I was spreading myself thin. And lo and behold, in the last week, I've broken 500 subscribers and literally like now as of the day of recording, it's like 515. And I have no idea how that's even happened. I haven't been posting a lot of videos. I haven't even posted a single video in 2 weeks. And now all of these people are finding my channel. Why? Because I'm in the right mental state and energetic state for these people to find me. I'm not posting videos from this frantic energy of growth. I'm posting videos that feel good to me during a time in my life where my health and wellness are my priority. And let me tell you, when you start making yourself and your health and your wellness a priority, it feels really good. At first, it doesn't feel natural. I feel like so many of us, particularly women, tend to be these people pleasers and we want to make everyone happy. And so we agree to all of these plans with our friends. We stay up extra late to watch just one more episode of that show with our favorite person. We maybe take on a little more than we can chew at work. And as a result, we don't have time to get home and make all these healthy, good, natural, organic meals for ourselves. And it is us who suffers. So it may feel like we're doing the right thing by doing all these things to make other people happy, but ultimately we are punishing ourselves. And that does not feel good when you're doing it. I spent 35 years doing it. And in the last 3 months, I have truly made myself a priority. My amazing, gorgeous, loving, sexy husband, there are times that I leave him on the sofa all by his lonesome so I can go to bed to get my full 8 hours of sleep because I know that's what I need for my body to feel its best. There are times that I turn down plans with friends because I know if I go out and spend half a day Saturday hanging out with my girlfriends and then another half a day or a full day on Sunday doing the same thing with another group of friends, I'm not going to have time to meal prep or to clean my house. And then the rest of my week is going to be thrown off. And so I've started saying no to people a lot more. But by saying no to them, I'm saying yes to myself, as cheesy as that sounds. And it shouldn't be considered selfish to make yourself and your health a priority, but it so very much is. And so I'm giving you guys permission to be selfish, to make yourself a priority, because in doing so, in loving yourself and in feeling good, you are empowering yourself to be so much stronger and to be able to manifest things so much more quickly. It is okay to want to treat yourself well and treat yourself nicely. You always hear people talk about treat yourself, and whenever you think about treat yourself, it'll usually be associated with like getting a pedicure or buying a nice shirt or something like that. But really, treating yourself is eating healthy, drinking lots of water, taking time to exercise, even if it's just going for a 20-minute walk around your neighborhood, taking time to put your health and yourself first. That is treating yourself. All of those other things can come too, but those should come second to putting your health as a priority. So you don't hear a lot in this community people talking about eating organic or eating healthy or meal prepping or whatever. If you want me to do a video on how to do healthy eating on the low, I can do it. It's not really in line with this particular niche, but I'm happy to expand on it if you guys want me to. But you don't really hear a lot about those kind of things in the law of attraction community, but I really think that we should start advocating for that as well. Aside from affirmations, visualizations, gratitude, meditation, all of those things, making yourself and your health, mental health, physical health, spiritual health, emotional health, a priority is so important. And now that I've been doing that and prioritizing my health, so many wonderful things are coming into my life. And I am so happy and I feel so good knowing that for my goals, for what I know is coming next in my life, which is a family with my amazing husband, I know that I am preparing the very best vessel that I can for our child. And that feels so good as well. And I know will only help me manifest my baby, because now not only am I emotionally ready for our baby, I am physically ready too, because I put so much time and effort into just allowing myself to be healthy and well. So I hope that you found this topic helpful. If you did, click like, maybe drop a comment in the comment section below. I want to hear from you guys. Is health and wellness something that you associate with the law of attraction? If so, why? And if not, why not? Sound off, let me know. Oh, and let me know what you think about this background. I'm in my backyard right now. I wanted to mix it up a little bit. See you guys in the next video. Bye, friends.